Now today we will see one more topic that is related to sharpening also, and that is known as unsharp masking. Unsharp masking and one more point that is known as high boost filtering. These two small things you should know, because sometimes question may be asked based on these two topics. But unsharp masking is the one way of sharpening your image. Last time we have seen about different techniques for sharpening, Laplacian operators, and how to apply Laplacian operator, how to get back your image from your blurred image. So unsharp masking is one of the very popular operation, you can say, in printing industry. In printing industry and publishing, printing or publishing, anything you can say. Printing and publishing industry, unsharp masking is a very popular operation to find out sharpen images. If you your target is to get back more sharpen images, so Laplacian gives you result, but if you want to get in a better way more sharpen image, then you better take unsharp masking scheme. Or sometimes you want to highlight much more details, you can say, in your image, more sharpen image you want, then you can do high boost filtering operation also. So these two are very important process to get more sharpened or higher sharpened images. This process, simply unsharp masking, you can see, is simply a process of subtract. You can simply subtracting. You are simply subtracting your unsharp image or smooth image. Whenever you get your blurred image, so after smoothing, you get one image. So you have done over image what application you have applied. You applied over image smooth. You get your blurred image. Okay, so blurred image. So whenever you are subtracting your original image, let's say FXY, from your blurred image, okay, you get what? This version of image always you get from, once you are subtracting this from this, you are getting high frequency component. You are getting what? You are getting your high frequency component. And this high frequency component image, now you will use as a mask. To apply this mask over your original image. Okay, so once you are subtracting your blurred image or smooth image from your original image, you are getting high frequency component of your image. This component, high frequency component, you will be using as a mask over your original image to make your image more sharpened in nature. So roughly you can see, first step was what? In original image, first step, what you will do? You will simply blur the original image. Step number one, to do unsharp masking, what you will do? First of all, you will blur your image. So that is a smoothing operation. Second, now you will subtract. What you will do? You will subtract your blurred image. This point is here. You are subtracting your blurred image from original image that I have told you. You need to subtract blurred image from your original image, and this resulting difference is basically, whenever you are doing subtraction, that is known as mask. The answer that we have got in the last step, I have told you, that is becoming your mask. And mask is a, in this mask you are having high frequency component, and now you are applying this mask, adding this mask or convolution operation, you can say, adding mask to its original image. Adding mask to its original image. So in this way, you are getting your data and you are doing your unsharp masking. Now we'll see mathematically how unsharp masking we are doing and high boost filtering we are obtaining in results. So roughly, if you see mathematically, what will be the formula you'll be getting for unsharp? I am writing like unsharp masking as a UM and high boost filtering as HF. Okay. So unsharp masking is nothing. You are getting a frequency component of FXY, sharp image. Sharpen image you will be getting what? When you are subtracting your FXY to which thing? The blurred image. f bar of xy, where f bar of xy is nothing, it's a blurred. So mathematically it's the same thing. Original image, blurred image is subtracted from original image, you are getting a mask, and that is known as sharpened mask, and you are applying, that is known as unsharp masking. So this unsharp masking is a method of sharpening your image by using, not directly sharpening operation, by first of all obtaining your blurred image, subtracting original image, getting its mask, and then applying over your original image. So in that way you will get more sharpened image. So and high boost filtering is nothing, it's basically boosting. Boosting means you are multiplying something over your mask, over your filter mask. So high boost filtering, roughly if you see mathematically, high boost filter, if I am representing through HF, let's say, then mathematically it will be represented like function of high boost, HB. Boost is HB, let's say. High boost HB, you can write. HB will be represented for XY. Function of high boost filter will be, or mask will be represented like multiplying factor. You are high boosting, you are amplifying your original image fxy by some factor, let's say factors a, and same operation is there, subtracting from your blurred, subtracting from your blurred image. Only difference between unsharp masking and high boost is there, in high boost you are amplifying, you are multiplying a constant factor here, and based on this a you can achieve a better result. High sharpened image you can result based on this, but there is also a limitation, how much more to how much extent you can make it sharpen, but this factor is giving you a better result compared to unmask. But roughly formula is same, but this amplification formula will gives you what, will gives you a simply much more better results. So if you mathematically, if you want to see, simply same thing, same equation for f bar xy, we can write like this, putting the value from here to here, f of hb of xy is nothing, a of f of xy, minus of fxy will be nothing, it's a minus, and what is fxy, fs of xy, f sharpen image of xy, minus f of xy, substituting this value, okay, so this will be nothing, it's a what, it's simply minus minus a, this is a minus, simply what, a minus 1, this will be f of s you can say, or f of xy you can say, anything you can say, this will be a minus, minus of fxy, minus will be there, f of xy, if you're taking it, okay, this will be fxy minus fs of xy, this will be like this, okay, so this will be a minus 1, f of xy. Minus and minus will become what? This minus and this minus will become what? This will be plus f of x. So this is a factor that you are multiplying. So if this is a simply what? It's a 1. Then it becomes a normally unmasked kind of situation. If it is greater than 1, then only you are getting a filter whose nature will be high boost in nature. So if you see the same thing, we can use for sharpening our Laplacian operator. Fs of xy could be your Laplacian operator. So roughly in case of high boost filter, what we are simply doing, we are simply nothing we are doing in a high boost kind of filter of situation. We are simply amplifying our fxy plus, if for sharpening, we are obtaining, let's say, del square f of x xy. That was nothing, that's a Laplacian operator. So you using this Laplacian operator along with this amplification factor, you will be getting your high boost filter. Now this high boost filter is, in the last lecture also I have told you about extended Laplacian operator. In the extended Laplacian operator, you know, if your filter was, let's say, 4 here, okay, 4 was here, and then 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 was there, general nature you can say, or minus 4 is there, then all 4 were positive 1, then in that case what you do, simply you increase it by 1, that will give you what, enhanced your Laplacian filter. So same thing is here, if you are trying to relate with your high boost filter, with your expanded, you can say, Laplacian filter, that is a one way you can say your enhanced Laplacian operator. So rather than writing it here, we can write it like this, minus 1, 0, 0, minus 1, this will be a plus 4, let's say. I am writing like a plus 4. So you can see, if I am taking a value a is equal to 1, it will become 5 and it will behave like your enhanced Laplacian operator. If I am taking value more than 1, then it will become what? It will become your high boost filter. So simply, if example comes to you, value of amplification factor will be given to you over your general Laplacians, over your general, you can say, Laplacian operator. So based on given A, using your general four different kind of Laplacian operator we have seen last time, you can simply get the result by applying its high boost filter. So I think most of the things I have covered. Now we'll take one example of high boost filter and this will give you more idea about it. Now take one question about high boost filter. High boost filter, simply question is like this. Simply you'll get like, apply high boost filter HPF over a given image. Over a given image, let's say image is given like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And high boost filter over a given image you have to apply over a center pixel, let's say. Pixel is also given to you. If not given, you just simply pad it, as I have told you in the past also. Let's say for pixel 1, 1 is given to you, or center pixel is given to you, and you have to apply your HBF with a value, let's say, is given as 1.7. So what you have to do? Nothing, simply this. You choose your any Laplacian operator. Let's say this time I'm choosing as in between 8 here, okay? So a plus 8 was there, then minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. You can choose it here, minus 1, minus 1. This will be minus 1, this will be minus 1, this will be minus 1. This is a normal Laplacian operator which simply changes here, just like expanded Laplacian operator. Value of a is given to you, just you multiply it, sum of the product kind of situation, convolution operation, you will get back your result. So simply results you will be getting like minus 1 is multiplied by all except 5. So that will be giving you what? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 plus 9. These all are multiplied by minus 1. And what is multiplied by a plus 8? 5. 5 is multiplied by a plus 8, where a is nothing, 1.7 plus 8. So you will be getting like what? You will be getting like minus 40 plus, this will be 8 plus 1.7, 9.7, 9.7 multiplied by 5. So 9.7 multiplied by 5, 9.5 to 45, it will be coming like 48.5. So roughly your answer will be in positive and it will be 8.5. So this pixel will be replaced after high boost filtering operation with 8.5. So major change in sharpening of this pixel you can see. If you are applying a simple operator, then your answer will be a little bit less. If you are applying some high boost, because your amplification factor, you can say you are applying it here, that value will be much more sharpened in nature. That is the meaning of unsharp masking and high boost filtering. That's all in this topic. We will see frequency domain in next topic.